Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. We all know what the Mishnah says in Pirkei Avos, mitzvah gereres mitzvah, that once somebody gets to do a mitzvah, he's so excited and he gets so into the mood of the positive behavior that he finds a way how one mitzvah becomes sort of an addiction. One mitzvah leads to another mitzvah and you feel very good. Now, as it is in the positive sense, the one good deed leads to the next good deed, we find a very fascinating thing that lahavdil in the negative is the same way. As the Mishnah says, va'aveira gereres aveira, but that's in spiritual matters. Let's talk in physical, just mundane life. Shlomo HaMelech says that somebody who is an oyev kesef, somebody who loves money, will never be satisfied with the amount of money he has. Whatever millions of dollars he'll have, he'll always want more and more and more. Money, 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 money. He'll never be happy. He'll always walk around, how can I make another dollar? So because he's never happy with what he has, it's an addiction. It's interesting that the Klei Yoker in Chumash Bereishis Perek Dalet Pasuk Yud Zayin says a phenomenal remez. He says, money in Hebrew and Lashon Kodesh is kesef. The three letters, chaf, samach, pei, which makes up the word kesef, money, divide those three letters and see what letters are very close to it. Next to the letter chaf is the letter yud. Next to the letter samach is the letter nun. And next to the letter pei is the letter ayin. So you have kesef, chaf, samach, pei. The letters that are near it are ayin, nun, yud. What does ayin, nun, yud spell? Ani. Poor. Sometimes, if a person doesn't stop, you should know that with the money, you're actually acquiring a level of being poor, because you're going to be running around catching your own tail. You're never going to be satisfied. And there is another remez that the Klei Yoker says in Parshas Chayesara. He says another word for money in Hebrew is mamon. Mamon means money. It is very interesting that the letters that you spell out the word mamon, mem, mem, vav, nun, every one of those letters, the miloi, that means if you would spell out the letter, mem is mem, mem. Vav is vav, vav. That's how you spell out the letter. Nun is nun, nun. That other letters, aleph, it's aleph, lamed, pei. These three letters is very unique. That the what you see of the letter and what's hidden in the letter is the same thing. It's just repeating the same. Money, 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 money. That's what mumming is. So you keep on chasing unless you stop. Now, if you stop and you realize God's bracha that He gave you, and this is what it's meant to be used for, then it's actually also a beautiful lesson from the word mumming. That the same money that you have, if it's samui min ha'ayin, if it's concealed and hidden and didn't done in a modest way, then there is bracha. So the same word mumming has another mumming behind it, as long as it is concealed. And this is what we have to learn. We have to learn to make sure not to realize that it's Hashem's bracha that he gives every individual. And yes, as it is in Kedusha, Mishi Yesh Leimana Reitza Masayim, and a mitzvah, Gereres mitzvah. But when it comes to physical matters, when it comes to materialistic matters, slow down and appreciate what you have. And as the famous vort is, Bashamayim Mimao. When you're talking about spiritual matters, always look at somebody who has more than you and say, halavai, I could be a tzaddik like him. Halavai, I could do Torah mitzvahs like him. But v'alaoretz, when it talks about artius, when it talks about materialistic things, physical things, always look mitachas. Always look at somebody who has less than you. And look, Baruch Hashem has blessed you with what you have.